Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Mediocre Manor. And it's the day after Christmas, and today I decided that I would spend the whole day outside working on the travel trailer. I really want to get that bathroom finished, and I want to move on to the front area. Maybe test that propane heater out today, and start making some other plans to move forward with that thing. So that's what I'm going to do. It's about 8 o'clock right now. The sun is just coming up over the trees here. I've got my coffee. Stephanie went out to volunteer at the local pig shelter. It's not really a shelter, it's a rescue, but she goes there every Wednesday and volunteers for a couple hours. So I've got the place to myself. It's me, Sammy, and Stella right now, and we're going to head over to the trailer and get started. Hopefully we get a lot done today. What we did last night was just leave everything. Normally we clean up. This was my makeshift wood cutting area, and I was using those boards there to prop all the other boards up. And so we left that. Got my little boombox here. I'll be plugging that in shortly. Listening to some classic rock. And this is the workspace. I know you guys have seen it before. I think I'm going to start picking up some of this today because it's supposed to rain tomorrow. I started using this little bucket. I was constantly leaving tools inside the trailer or over at Amy's van. So I've had one of these little things laying around. It goes inside a bucket and it's got all different little tool holders and things like that. And then you can still use the inside of the bucket. So as I've been using things, I've been putting them back in that, and hopefully I'll be able to carry that around with me. So I didn't really do too much last night after Christmas. I did put the sink base in here. I got it cut out. The sink doesn't really fit yet, so I need to do a little bit more cutting. I actually used the Dremel tool, and I didn't really like it too much. You can kind of see it's like a wavy line. It was kind of like a router. It kind of wanted to take off on me, so I'm going to have to clean that up with the jigsaw probably. The other thing that I did was I used these 1x2 pine strips, and I just kind of rebuilt this rot over here. If you can really see it, the whole corner was pretty much just this piece here was rotted. I don't have it, but anyways, it was just kind of that dead wood down here, so I just, these are all replacements. So I put this piece in here to fill where the rot was, and then I just sistered them for strength on that side with those two. And as ugly as this is, I think I'm going to leave that today. I'm just going to, it wiggles just a little bit, so I'm going to put some sister supports in there, help clean that up. We're going to come over this side. This is going to be the big project today, is to get this corner rebuilt. So, anyways, yeah, the plan is to just come right down with the side pieces first and then keep building off that. And I also have to replace the base over here. I'd really like to get all this done today. So I'm gonna get started. Okay, so here's what my plan is here. I'm gonna put a piece of wood up next to that and cut that one out with the rod, where the rod is. And if you don't have one of these, I wanted to show you. These oscillating tools with the little blade. Put a wood blade on there. This one's a Bosch. My father, Tim, got me this a few years ago, and this has been such a help because with a little cut like that, I don't know if you can see it, I guess I'll come down here to show you. To get a cut like that would normally be very difficult, but with this, you can just slice right in surgically, right where you want it to be. And so that's what I'm gonna do up there. I'm gonna cut that and put a new piece in there. And this is such a mess, but I'm really looking forward to this part being over, so let's get going. Okay, before I go any further, I need to replace those two bottom boards. Like the one that goes under the door here. And that'll lead up to the outside of this, which I just replaced this little section. From here to here is new, so that I can screw into this. I'm gonna put this outside piece here, and then this outside piece here, and then I can build off those. So the closest thing I could find for that would be a split 2x4. So that's what I've got over here now. Found this 2x4 that came from an old deck. Pull the nails out of it and slice it. And hopefully get the diameter that I need. Now we're here at the back corner, and what I just did was I sliced this piece of wood here. It looked very similar to this, it was rotten, and I measured back 12 inches from what would be the corner, and I cut it off with my oscillating tool, and then I cut this piece of pine that's pretty much the same. It's a little bit off, but it's pretty much the same diameter as this, and that will be the piece that goes in there. For support, I have this long 1x2 piece of pine that's going to go all the way over to this one, kind of hold it up like a brace. I don't know if you can see it or not, but these back two pieces, back where the top frame comes down and the bottom frame comes down, there's actually, they angled it. They're not flush on each other, they're angled just a little bit, and so if I were to put this up flush, this would stick out here. There's a lip here. So I had to figure out a way to continue this gap, and so what I did was I went and got some pine shims, and what I'm gonna do is I'm going to try to use the shims to keep the angle consistent all the way down, and then screw the nails in and hopefully achieve the same gap all the way down. It's gonna be difficult, but that's my plan. I'm just gonna eyeball it because there's really no way for me to get this perfect. That's why we call it Mediocre Manor. It's not perfect, but it's gonna be pretty damn close. This will be better right like this. So now I've got this angle coming all the way down. I'm going to measure back to a certain point and cut this, replace it, try to get the angle right, and then screw everything together. All right, this piece here, that we don't want it like that, we want it like this. So there's an angle. So I'm gonna do the same thing I did here. I'll put this one on to span the two, and then I'll put wedges in here until this angle looks the same, screw everything down, and then put some wedges in here, screw these together, and then remove my support. That looks pretty good. There we go. Looking pretty good. Yeah, just cut this base piece from a 2x4 And now I'm about to see if it fits in here. I don't know why there's a Q-tip in here. It's gross. This is another piece of pressure treated from the deck boards out in the yard. I think I need to feed it in behind that trailer hitch. Because it's going to be tight. Okay, what I'm going to do for this is I'm going to use a couple 2.5-inch screws to just tack it on there, and then I'm going to use, I've got these lag bolts, and I'm going to go ahead and space apart 4 of those and drive those in. Ow! One on each end and 2 in the middle to kind of hold that in. Alright, as you can see, I've got this base piece in. I countersunk it, these holes, and now I've got this socket set. I'm just going to finish it up there. Get it in there nice and tight. And then I can finish that section. Hopefully I can get this done today. It's been a long day. It's about, I'm guessing it's got to be around 2:30 right now. Alright. Right side's pretty much done. What we're dealing with over here now, this is what I did before. I've got to bring this 2x4, or this board, I've got to continue it down here on an angle. So that means since this piece is up, I'm going to remove this piece. And I really don't want to take all this out. This piece is also kind of jacked up, so I'm going to take this out, put another piece in here, a piece here that fits. So remove, another piece, put one in, and then I'm going to do something about down here and wrap this project up. There's all the old rotted wood. One of my favorite parts of any project is burning all the old crappy rotted wood. Oh, I guess I'm burning that metal right now. So anyways, it's all set for the day. Pretty much got all the framing done. And I'll show you now everything that I did. There she is. So all this is new down the side. I reinforced all this. You can see how strong that is now. It's not even wiggling. This is where the left tail light will go. I got my new bottom piece that's lag bolted in 4 places. Down here, this was the worst of it. This whole corner was just completely rotted out. It's all built up again now, very strong. The whole side is completely built up. Came down with the angle and see how this is where the two pieces meet here and overlap on this seam with the angle. And then I came over to the door. Oh, these two pieces down here under the door, this piece back here, and then this piece here, and then the door frame on the left side. I came up to here where I cut it. This is all new. This is new. And then I just have this one little piece here to do. And I have one piece here to do so that the right tail light can go in here. And that's pretty much it. That's where I'm going to wrap it up for today. So we'll head over and see what Amy did today. Jake's going to the vet. He doesn't know where he's going yet, so he's excited. But once he gets there, he'll probably pee on the floor.
You ready, Dookie?
Good luck, Jake. So what'd you do today?
I finished getting all my
looks nice
ribs filled in.
Wow.
So now I can put the top layer of foam on.
So, okay, so you filled all the depressions with this, and then you're going to put one of these over everything?
Yep.
Wow. Is that ready to go tonight, or is that going
to... It's already cut, yeah, I just have to...
Oh.
I had to put the piece of wood underneath where the seam is, and then...
Oh, so we have to cut that first.
Yep, and then I can put the foam pieces in that I already pre-shaped.
Yeah.
I just have to fine-tune them, and then the floor can go on top of that.
Cool. All right. Did you wipe that off? It looks dirty.
I put my concrobium spray on there.
Okay, so we're going to try to put this in. This is the back or the front?
I'm going to put it in. It's the back.
This is the back. So we'll go right in the back door, kind of at an angle maybe. Try to set it down.
Yeah.
Without breaking those two things on the end.
Yeah.
All right.
Good. That seam. Right down the middle.
Now we can walk on it.